beautiful people, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for your love and support as always. I'm so grateful. If to those the first time you are coming across this channel and you are seeing my face for the first time, this is Agatha Progress channel, and I come across your way every blessed day. In this channel, we bring the best of news to your doorpost through this channel. And in this channel, correction is highly needed. Thank you very much once again for always tuning in. I am so grateful. Now, here is the video of the day. I don't really know how you felt about this video, but your opinion is highly needed in the comment section. Now, let's go and watch the video together. We all are aware about the report that reaches us today about how unknown gunmen went to the prison Owerri, the Imo State capital to be precise, how they free all the prisoners there and set some vehicle ablaze. And we are here to talk about it. I have a video here how the illustration started. They take us around the town of Owerri. What is really going on right now? How the place look like? The people passing by, the vehicle, and everything that is involved in this attack. Now, let's bring our own idea to what just happened, our own perspective, what we understand by everything that really transpired in Owerri. According to the source, they said when the unknown gunmen arrived there, the statement they made to everybody as they free the prisoners is, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Go home and sin no more. Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. Go home and sin no more. You are not supposed to be here. That is the gospel they preach to the prisoners. So let's begin to take some, pick out some words or take some ideas or take some things from the statement being made. What did you understand by those words? When somebody say, go home, your sins has made you old. Jesus Christ has been risen from the dead. You don't supposed to be here. It's just like preaching the gospel to someone. It's just like preaching the gospel of redemption to people. As earlier said, that even the police vehicle that were there, they were all burnt. And when the police or the army saw that, the unknown gunmen, they came with about 10 vehicles and they overthrew them, they started running away. So now tell me, where is the security? These people will spend a lot of money each day to say we have security, or we are fighting insecurity in the country, or we are deploying some armies. But still, they ran away when they saw the unknown government coming. And now for this thing that happened, according to the very reliable source, now they are trying to bring more armies, navy, and every other thing they can ever think about to Biafra land. And this got me so scary. The innocent ones are the ones that are going to pay for this. Anyway, we just hope for the best to come. I have to drop the video for you to view your eyes.
Diana, there is a corpse lying there, a dead body of a man lying there. But because the prison officials cannot allow me to have access into the premises, we'll be giving you updates on what is happening from this part. You can see there. Right from the information I gathered, about 1:02 a.m. this morning, 1:02 a.m., gunmen operating in over 10 vehicles attacked a Owerri correctional prison, freeing 80% of the inmates. My source told me that on getting access into these premises, the gunmen asked all the inmates to go home, that Jesus has risen and they have no reason to be here. Apart from freeing them, they attacked some operational vehicle and the building itself. So as you can see here, there are no official statement from the authority of the Owerri correctional prison. But all we can tell you that all is not well with this very facility. All the inmates, almost all the inmates have been freed by the government. You can also see the bags. These are some of the bags. As we go closer now, you can see some of the bags, some of the bags of the IMF as they ran, as they were free. These are some of their bags. This right here is the frontage of the Owerri
Correctional
Prison. These are their bags. Some of their bags are some of their is belongings as they fled. So you can see there are no vehicular movements on this express road. That is palpable fact. Apart from attacking diesel. Apart from attacking this facility, this correctional center facility, the government also attacked the police command headquarters in Owerri. So after now, I will be taking you to the police command headquarters. They also attacked it and freed almost all the suspects in the state investigation department of the section. My source told me that the only unit that was not attacked at the police command headquarters was the anti-kidnapping unit. The reason was that that unit is not inside the command headquarters. So after attacking the police divisional headquarters, the government also drove to a place called Upoch on Owerri, on Onitsha Expressway, where there is a military base.
Oh my word, that is all about this video. Hope you do enjoy this video. Please, if you know you haven't subscribed to this wonderful channel, do well to subscribe, like, and share. Thank you very much for always tuning in. And if you watch your video to this very end, you are the best. See you again in my next post shortly. See you when I see you. Bye-bye.